Thank you. Thank you. My name is Mark Mummert. I'm the cantor here at Trinity Lutheran Church in Worcester, and we are so grateful to you, Peter, for having just played the accompaniment to the Luther film in honor of Luther's birthday on November 8th. So thank you so much for coming here to play the instrument and to do this video. I'm wondering what is it about this instrument that you enjoy, and what excites you about playing this film with this instrument?
Well, first of all, it's in a way a landmark instrument, as you already know. It's just in a magnificent setting, acoustically. The instrument has the voices that, you know, Bach himself would have been used to these voices and this action. It would have been different, but still very close. And it thrills me that during this time period when Luther was alive, these were the sort of sounds that they would have heard. Just as importantly, the acoustic of the building lends itself to that historical context, but also, more importantly, the fact that this is a Lutheran church makes this film here so extraordinary. In your hallway, you have a piece of wood from a tree that Luther rested under. In this very building is this artifact. And so it's things like that that really excite me when I can see a venue, a people, the congregation, the audience that has seen this film now, and experienced this story that relates in so many different levels, venue, instrument, acoustic, and even artifact. It's right. Really remarkable.
Right. Is it likely that people would have seen this film, Luther, that was made in, 1928? Or
in the 20s. In
early 20s. Is it likely that people saw this film in a movie house? And would they have seen it with an organ accompaniment in the movie house?
I don't know what was going on entirely in German film at that time in terms of accompaniments, but from what I understand, there was more of the possibility of an orchestra.
An orchestra.
And maybe even a score that has been lost or we don't know. There was also the orchestras and film music here in America. Individuals with organs and pianos had a book that was a scene-by-scene library of love scene, train wreck, bomb attack.
Wow.
And you go in this big book. And
wow.
There would be, this is what makes it funny, Schubert, Chopin, Dvorak.
Oh, no kidding.
Would be these excerpts for the people that just didn't improvise.
Right.
And these musical scores were blended together often by either a house musician in that theater or the movie went out with an actual score. Now, I know that right away, now that I've said this, there'll be 20 people saying, didn't you know that this composer wrote this music for that movie? But that's what's cool about the internet, because
yeah, sure.
We can find things that we didn't know existed. In this case, all the music you've heard was improvised, but specifically for this building, for this instrument, for this movie, and for this audience.
That's tremendous. Well, thank you so very much for coming again, for playing this instrument for us. We hope that you all enjoyed watching this film and hearing Peter's improvisation during the film. And we hope that if you did enjoy it, that you'll choose now to make a donation to Music at Trinity. Our series here at Trinity Lutheran Church depends on the generosity of our donors. We did not charge you to watch this film, but we are asking you to now find a way to get a donation to us so that we can continue to offer these opportunities, especially in this time when it's been a little bit of a challenge to provide for folks live or semi-live musical events. So again, Peter, thank you so much for coming and playing for us today. And we look forward to seeing you online the next time we have an opportunity here at Music at Trinity to make music for you. All the best to you. Good night.